दिस अपेरेंट डे ऑफ जगत गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद स्वतश्री समर भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद ही प्रीत फॉर होल वर्ल्ड दे मिशन ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is combined of Radha and Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also preached that how to achieve the love and affection of Krishna. We are always coming and going from this world, thinking that I am this body and this is mine. But we are not truly there. We are soul and Krishna is super soul here. After death, you will see that you cannot take a farthing, ringgit or anything from this world. Your father, mother, sister, brother, son, daughter, anyone will accompany with you. No one. So, will have to go empty-handed. So, we should realize this. Who am I? Who is Krishna? And what is our relation? And before death, we should try to know these things. For this, all incarnations of Krishna comes, Krishna himself comes with his whole associate. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes, Krishna comes with a whole, his associate with, in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Gaur Gadadhar and others. And in whole world they preach this mission. That is why Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur appeared in this world with so many associates, very qualified, and by that he preached our whole world his mission, that we are not body, we are eternal servant of Krishna. Only for this, and to do bhajan, practice bhakti yoga, Krishna has given this human form. Not for enjoyment, not for marrying, not for any enjoyment, not for decorating body or anything. Only to maintain our life, we can do any business, any service or anything. But mostly, all should be for Krishna bhajan. Otherwise, your life will be ruined. You cannot be happy here in this world and transcendental world. If you want to be happy, then you should follow the process of Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bhagavat, Chaitanya, Chaitamita and be happy forever. So how Prabhupada came in this world? Oh, you should tell something brief about Srila Prabhupada. Stand up. I come only to remind these all these things, not always be engaged in your services and your householder life. Only for these, in this old age, I am coming.
यादतिमरादस्य गिरंदनसलाकय चक्षुरुन्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुवे नमः. वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृतसिन्धुभैः च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमद्भक्तिसिद्धान्त सरस्वती First of all, I offer my thousands of heartfelt Pushpanjali obeisances and dandavasa to the lotus feet of my Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pare Paramahamsa Pari Prakacharya Vastatata Sri Srinivad Bhakti Vedanta Sri Narayan Goswami Maharaj. After that, I offer my dandavat pranam to all the acharyas in our Guru Parampara, especially today, on this most auspicious day, disappearance day of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. I beg for a drop of his mercy that I can, on the order of Sri Guru, share with you some of his glories. I also offer my humble obeisances unto all the Tridandi sannyasis and all the devotees who have come here today, guests, mothers, sisters, brothers, to hear the glories of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, how to do bhajan from the lotus lips of Srila Gurudev. So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, he was the greatest gift to this world. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his illustrious father, he is also glorified and known as the seventh Goswami, Saptam Goswami, Sachit Ananda Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He gave all the Vaishnavas, the whole world, the yoga pit or the appearance place, the meeting place of Srila Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Sri Mayapur, Navadvip. And he brought into this world Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. So history will be indebted to the great contribution that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada has brought to this world. From young age, as he appeared in this world, his glories are unfathomable. In Jagannath Puri, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he lived there. At that time, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta appeared. From birth, he had, as a baby, the signs of Tilak, 12 auspicious signs. Kanti Mala was there, the signs. And then umbilical cord was draped like Brahman Prat Upanaya. His father and mother became overjoyed. At that time, Rath Yatra was going on, and the car stopped in front of the house where Srila Bhaktisiddhanta just had appeared. And father offered him to the lotus feet of Sri Jagannath Dev. Then a garland fell from Srila Sri Jagannath Dev onto the baby. Very auspicious. His father and mother called him Bimal Prasad. And from young age, he was always assisting his father. His father was a Paramahamsa Mahabhagavat Vaishnava, always absorbed in the angas of pure bhakti. He used to go and give class in different places, and from young age his son would come with him and carry grantha on his head or with him, assisting Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. He would go to school, but he was not impressed at all with the presentation of the teachers. Why? Because from his father he had heard the glories of pure bhakti, the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission, the glories of the process, which is really beneficial for the living entities. How to do bhajan, how to practice our different activities in life so that we can progress and attain the lotus feet of of Sri Krishna, the eternal service of Sri Krishna. So whatever he learned in school, very quickly he was disinterested with that. Yeah, although the teachers, they would like to keep him. Yeah. And he knew so much astrology. Yeah, he was very expert in astrology, but he left all these things behind. Why? Because these things, they cannot help the living entity. If we know all, if we can count all the stars in the sky, yeah, what benefit will it be for us? Yeah. If we know, yeah, what is the amount of sand on the beach of the oceans, any benefit? Yeah. For the eternal Atma, yeah? Mm. Only benefit for the Atma Vijay. Is...
Mm. What?
Only benefit for the living entity is
when he can Brahmachari
somehow or another
sitting
yeah,
behind.
Come in the association of pure sadhus. Yeah. This is the real benefit for the living entity. So Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, from the beginning of his life, he was in the association of his father. His father initiated him in mantra to worship Kurumadev. And at that time his father, when he left school, he was worried, how shall I engage my son so that he will become... Fathers always want that their children should be responsible, take a job and earn something to learn to maintain themselves in life. So he arranged...
You can't hear?
Some facility that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada would be engaged in, some medical shop, but it was failure. Yeah. Later on, the king nearby, there was a king living, and he was looking for a tutor, yeah, a private teacher for his son, yeah, to help his son develop, yeah, good character and knowledge, what is going on in this world, so that he would be ideal. So he asked Srila Bhakti Natakur, can your son, yeah, be engaged as a tutor for my son? Sure, yeah, I will give him good salary. King said, no problem. Yeah. Then Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada went there. And what did he do? He taught King's son, yeah, how to be renounced from this world, how to be interested to develop our relationship with Krishna, yeah, and how life is really meant for that. And if you are really interested to look after your progeny, the population in this world, and teach them how to engage in bhajan. Yeah. Well, son was very happy, yeah, but her mother was not happy. Queen was thinking, oh, now my son will be renounced, he will not marry, he will not be king. Yeah. What to do? So she spoke with her husband, and she told her husband, if you continue to have this Bimala Prasad, at that time his name, yeah, teach my son, I will take poison and die, yeah, at once. So king was thinking, yeah, this is the weapon of ladies, they will threaten at any time. If you don't do what I say, I will take poison and die, commit suicide. Yeah. So king, he was forced, yeah, he told to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I am obliged, yeah, by the pressure, my wife, I'm very sorry, yeah, I like your son very much, but please take him back, and I will continue to pay his salary. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was not worried. Then, at that time, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur requested his son to look after, yeah, maintaining the place in Mayapur, the yoga pit, or the appearance place of Srila Bhakti Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Yeah. And there, and at that time, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhu started, yeah, to prepare, yeah, for the mission to establish firmly the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And what more, yeah, he established, yeah, Gaudiya Math. Yeah. What is Gaudiya Math? Yeah. Gaudiya Math is the place, yeah, the birthplace for pure bhakti. Yeah. What is that pure bhakti? What is the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? As we have heard from our Guru Bhaga, yeah, that message is
आराध्यो भगवान ब्रजेश तमेय तद्धाम वृंदावनम रम्या कश्चित उपासना प्रजवधु वर्गेण यकल्पिता श्रीमद् भगवतां पारं प्रामणां अमलं प्रेम कुमार तमहं श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु मतम विदम तत्रारयो न परस. He firmly established Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is that? That the prime object, aim and object of our life should be to develop bhakti, pure bhakti for Brajanananda and Sri Krishna, for Braja, for all the parikas of Sri Krishna, especially under the guidance of Srimati Radhika. Moreover, what we really want to attain is that mood which those intimate associates of Srimati Radhika have in their heart, who have come to this world in the form of Sri Rupa Sanatan, Bhatta Raghunath, Dasa Raghunath, Gopala Bhatta, Sri Jiva Goswami, the intimate associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu particularly, which has been brought to us by Sri Rupa Goswami. Sri Chaitanya Manobishtam, Stapitam Yena Bhutale, Sayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada came to give this wealth to all living entities in this world. How did he do that? By establishing so many mats, 64 mats in India. Moreover, as we heard from Srila Gurudev, he ordered his followers, very qualified, they were the cream of Bengal society, whole Indian society. Young men like we see here, who left their homes, their families, they left the idea to get married and involved in so many responsibilities, look after children and have a job and responsibility in this world. They left all these ambitions. They followed Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada and became lifelong brahmacharis, sannyasis. And one of them was Srila Bhakti Prakyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj. From young age, he left everything, following in the footsteps of his own spiritual master, leaving school, at once, dedicating his whole life to the lotus feet of his spiritual master. In the example of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, we see how without such a glorious example, teacher, this world where we are now, Western world, whether we are in Malaysia, in America, in China, Russia, Europe, England, Australia, we would not have heard or known the glories of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we are eternally indebted to this great Mahapurush. How he gave his whole energy to establish firmly the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by printing books, by publishing magazines, even daily newspapers. One time there was a question, why you want to publish daily newspaper about the glories of Krishna? Then he replied, if they can write about ordinary things in this world, every day they can come out with so many newspapers, why we cannot every day bring out the glorious activities of Sri Krishna's eternal Nitya Lila? So every day there was newspaper available, very wonderful. In this time nowadays we see how difficult it is for us. But by mercy of Guru and Vaishnava still we are publishing books in so many languages. But how beautiful would it be if we have a daily message to all living entities? Nowadays it is possible. If we have internet, websites, every day on the website we can publish something beautiful, good message. So these are all the glories of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. And I have a little, I have shared with you, it is due to the glory of my beloved Gurudev, and I pray on this special day that Gurudev will always be kind to me and that I will obtain a drop of the mercy, that which the Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada came to give to us.
Now, Sriman Madhav Maharaj really speak the glory of Srila Prabhupada. In brief, Harinath Prabhu glorified very well in short period, and he told in brief, he told everything about Prabhupada. But he also has told, he should have told that his one warm Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj came to eastern western whole world, and in couple of years he preached over whole world, established preaching centers, publishing so many books and giving sannyas everywhere in the corner of whole universe, even in the midst of oceans, on the top of mountains, in the forests, here, there, I'm seeing his glory. I think that you have come only due to his preaching, reading his books. So his one warm deed, so there were so various arms of Srila Prabhupada who preached, and more qualified they were, even more qualified, to whom Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj used to call them Siksha Guru, to our Gurudev, to our Pujyapal Sridhar Maharaj, Vaikhanas Maharaj, and so many. So they are very, very qualified, like Prabhupada they were. Now,
नमस्ते गौरवाणी श्रीमूर्तये दीनतारिणे रूपानुग विरुद्धाप सिद्धांत धांत हारिणे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. First of all, I pay my humble obeisances to the trusted of my Paramaradha Guru Pada Padma, Om Vishnu Pada, Astravatar Sadasimad Bhakti Vedanta Sreva Amanda Singh Maharaj, and Om Vishnu Pada, Parivajaka Charja Varja, Astravatar Sadasimad Bhakti Vedanta Sreva Narayana Singh Maharaj. I pay my obeisances to the trusted of my spiritual grandsire, Nittarila Prasun Vishnupad, Slavukiran Sami Maharaj, and Nittarila Prasun Vishnupad, Slavukhi Pradhan Kesavu Sai Maharaj. I pay my obeisances, Narura Sutok, Slavukhi Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad, and all Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis who assembled here. Srila Gurudev ordered me to discuss something about the glory of Srila Prabhupada, but in brief. So as before you have heard from Srila Sripad Bhajanath Prabhu, that after his birth gradually he got title of Siddhanta Saraswati because he was the learned scholar in astrology at that time. So all astrological society, they kept the title, they never gave as before and not later on. They are so expert in astrology. So when he grew up, then his father gave him Nrisimha Mantra and Mahamantra and Kurmadev Mantra to worship Kurmadev. Now, after Harinam, time has come from initiation, Brahman initiation. Although Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada is very learned scholar, but in this society, people may think, oh, father is giving initiation to his own son like this. So, Bhakti Thakur desired that he can take initiation from Srila Gaurakisho Das Guruji Maharaj. Not only that, Srila Bimala Prasad Saraswati means Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada had a strong desire to be initiated by Srila Gaurakisho Das Guruji Maharaj. Then he approached to him, Gaurakisho Das Guruji Maharaj, okay, I have to ask Gaur Nityananda Prabhu. After a few days when he asked, oh, I forget. Again he asked, oh, I have to approach Gaur Nityananda Prabhu. By this way, he only passing the time. And he told, oh, he was a learned scholar, and he was son of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. I am illiterate. by this way he is passing time. But Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur, determined his mind, if I take initiation only from this liberated soul, I shall do or die. So, what to do now? He always refusing, then he start Chandrayan Vrata and eat by Gokras. So, what mean by Chandrayan Vrata? Like moon, increasing day by day up to full moon and decreasing day by day up to new moon. And Gokras means like we are eating by hand and cow eating by mouth. So, Prabhupada is to take anything keeping on the floor and by only mouth without the help of hand. One, today one bite, two bite, three bite, like this up to 16 bite full moon, and then 15, 14, 13, this is a new moon, nothing. And he became more skinny. And so Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that he want to kill this boy, why not initiate him? Then Srila Gopisata Subhaji Maharaj bound to initiate him. So you have to do something that Gurudev heart bound to melt, seeing your propensity. So then initiate him. So after initiation, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur disappeared from this world in 1914, and Srila Gopisata Subhaji Maharaj disappeared about 1915. After that, Srila Prabhupada started Satakoti Nam Yajna. Satakoti Nam Yajna means we are chanting, each chant 16 rounds, then called 25,000. If 4 times 16, then 1 lakh. By this way, if 10 times then 1 million, then 100 times then 10 million. By this way, Sata crore means 10 million is into 1 crore. So 10 million into 100. So many he is chanting now. Take some time. When he was doing his Sata Koti Nam Yajna, in the meantime, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, along with his associates like Nityananda Prabhu, Sri Advaitacharya, Sri Gadadhar Pandit, and Sri Vas Pandit, they came in his vision, give direct darshan and told, we have to preach the glory of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna's glory. Prabhupada, I am alone, how I can do that? Mahaputra, I have sent so many persons to you, they will come very soon to you, they will help you for preaching. So by that, our Paramurudev came, Srila Sridhar Maharaj came, all associates of like Bhaktan Swami Maharaj came, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj came, and they helped Prabhupada, Srila Saraswati Thakur. By this way, he preached his mission. And just you have heard from Srila Gurudev that his one arm came to the Western country and pitched all over the world. Just like his father had some desire, or father had some loan, could not pay, he disappeared from this world, then his responsibility to his son to pay the debt. In the same way, Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur had cherished desire to preach all over the world the glory of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sri Krishna. But in his lifetime, although he sent some his disciples, like Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pradip Tirtha Maharaj, Bhakti Van Maharaj, they preach in England. But after that, after his disappeared, Srila Bhakti Sami Maharaj, as his name was as before, of Sri Abhay Charanarabinda, he took renounce order from our beloved Paramurudev, Srila Bhakti Program Keshav Goswami Maharaj in Mathura Keshav Ji Gaudiya Math. And after that, he started preaching and spent so much time with Srila Gurudev in Mathura, and he started preaching all over the world and became a grand success. So, how is possible? By the causeless mercy of Gurudev Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. Unless until the Gurudev had bestowed mercy, then we could not be success in any bhajan. So, by this he got grand success. And I pray him that Namaste Gauravani Srimurtaye Dinatarine Sri Rupanuga Viruddhapa Siddhanta Dhanta Harine. Namaste Gauravani. I pray that Gauravani. What is Gauravani? There is Gurudev has not one book, Gauravani. There are two Gauravani. One is according to theory and one is according to Ras. What is theory? Amnaya Prahatattam Harimiya Paramam Sarva Sakti Rasabding Tad Dhinnam Sansta Jivan Praktikavalitan Tad Vimuktam Shabhavat Vedanada Prakasam Sakalopi Hare Sadhanam Suddha Bhaktim Saddham Tattime Pratibhusati Janang Gaurachandra Sansa. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur composed in slok form. Another Srila Vishwanatha Thakur has taught according to nature. Arata Bhagavan Prajisataniya Taddhama Vrindavanam Ramma Kajitupasana Prajakutuparigina Jakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prima Pumartho Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Vatavidam Tatra Daruna Paraha. The first one according to theory, according to Siddhanta, Amnaya. What is Amnaya? That is vast, very vast. Not possible for any human beings to read in one lifetime. So seeing this, Srila Vyasadeva make it in short form, like he did Vedanta Sutra. And he divided Vedas in four, like Rigveda, Samveda, Yajurveda, so still is so vast. So, what are Guru Parampara? Means Gurudev is Gurudev like this way. Who are they? Did bhajan and realize, and who are they accept as authentic? That Vedavani called Guru Parampara. It's called Amnaya. What Amnaya told? Amnaya praha tattam harimya paramam. For his supreme theory is non-dual absolute truth. Amnaya praha tattam harimya paramam. Sarva sakti la sadhya. He has all kind of potency, like jiva potency, antaranga potency, maya potency, etc. belongs to him. Sarva sakti la sadhya. Tad bhinnam sansa prakita kavalitam. And jiva is part and parcel of Krishna. This is Virinansa. This jiva is two types. Prakriti kavalitan tad vimuktansa bhava. One is conditioned soul, covered by maya, and a liberated soul. And Vedaveda prakasam, sakalopi hari, sadhanam, Vedaveda prakasam. What you have seen, these are manifestation of God, difference and non-difference. Why? Without the existence of God, there is no existence. So, non-difference and bhed is not as in Krishna, so from difference. Vedavada Prakasam, Sakalam, Hare Sadhanam Suddha Bhakti. How we can achieve Him? We have to do Sadhana Bhakti. Sadhana Bhakti is 64 times, then prominent is 9 times. Then Prahlad Maharaj told, Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasa, Sakhamatma, Nivedanam, Iti Pumsarkita, Vishnu, Bhakti, Stevana, Lakhana, Preet, Bhagavatam, Dhatan, Manyadita, Uttamam. 9 limbs of Bhakti. More special? 5 types. More? 3 types. More? 1. What is that? Param Viyate, Sri Krishna, Sankirtanam. If you do Sankirtan, when you are doing Sankirtan, then your whole mind will be absorbed in Sankirtan. So, Sadhanam Suddha Bhakti. Then what is the goal? Saddham Tat Priti. To make peace to Krishna, this is our Saddha, this goal. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told this by himself, and Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur make it in slok form. And other hand, according to Rasa, Sri Vishwanatha Thakur has told, Aradho Bhagavan Prajisa Tanaya. Who is our supreme Aradha? Bhagavan. Who is Bhagavan? Is Dharakadhis? Or Mutraji? No. Who? Brajendra Tanaya. Brajendra means Braja plus Indra according to Sanskrit grammar means Brajendra. Who is Brajendra? Nanda Baba. His son, Brajendra Tanaya. Aradho Bhagavan Brajisa Tanaya. Where he lives? Taddhama Vrindavanam. His abode is Vrindavan. Aradho Bhagavan Taddhama Vrindavanam. Ramma Kachit Upasana. How we can serve him? How we can do his bhajan? Kachit Upasana Ramma. Brajabadhu Banigira Jakarta. Ramma means very beautiful way. The Prajabadhu means the Praj Gopis, they serve Krishna. That way we have to adopt that thing. Then we are Prabhupada, followers of Sri Bhakti Sukhadhyam Prabhupada and his associates and his disciples. Ramma Kati Upasana Bhajantu Varje. What is the proof? Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam. Srimad Bhagavatam is spotless proof and the supreme proof for this. And Mahaprabhu, this is opinion we have. Honor for that, you have no other honor for other opinion. And it is pranam to Prabhupada. Namaste Gauravani, I explain about Gauravani. Srimurta Dinatarine, Rupanuga Viruddhapo, Siddhanta Dhanta Harine. He always refused the who is the against the Rupanuga Siddhanta. What is Rupanuga Siddhanta? The Rupa Saipat, what he explained us in this world to do bhajan, Sankha Purvaka Nama Gana Nativi, Kala Vasani Vito. Nidraha Vihara Kadi Vijita Uchaktanta Dina Uchajam राधा कृष्ण गुण स्मृतै मधुरिम आनन्दैन सम्मोहितौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुजिगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ शङ्खापूर्वक नाम यर टू चैंट सम फिक्स राउंड मिनिमम 16 राउंड्स जस्ट लाइक फॉर मेंटेनिंग आवर बॉडी वी आर एवरी डे टेकिंग फूड सेम वे टू मेंटेन आवर सोल टू मस्ट हैव टू चैंट हरिनाम एंड हैव टू लिसन सम हरि कथा टू रीड सम बुक्स सो संख्या पूर्वक नाम गान गान मीन्स इज प्रेयर लाइक वी डू गुरुवास्तव वैष्णव वंदना राधा कृपा कटाक्ष गोवर्धन श्री एटसेट हैव टू डू एवरी डे नाम गायन अति ज्ञान गुरु प्रणाम गुरुदेव भिस गुरुदेवाल गुरु परंपरा ब्रज धाम नवदीप धाम जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम एटसेट्रा नति नि काल आवर सानी हैव टू स्पेंड आवर लाइफ दिस वे एंड अदर हैंड रूप गोस्वामी व्हाट इज टेलिंग इज इन साधक फॉर्म इज डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग एंड सिद्ध फॉर्म तामुरार्पण पाद मर्दन उपायोदानामि सारा दिधि बिंदारा नमेश्वरी जात संति प्रिया लाइक दिस वे How is our divine couple? Who followed this Rupanuga Vaishnav? Anyone is against to this, then Prabhupada always refute their Siddhanta. So, but if we follow this way, then we are proper following Srila Prabhupada Sarasvati Thakurana Guru Parampara. And all we have assembled here to listen something from the lotus lips of Srila Gurudev and Gurudev give one condition to breathe. So I am finishing here if anything wrong. Due to my disability, if anything good, all credit will go to Srila Gurudev Lotus Feet. Hare Krishna. Vansha Kalpata Rupasya Kripa Sindhu Bhaya Vacha Patitana Pavane Bho Vasnavi Bho Namo Namo.
Ajnanat Virandhasya Jnanan Jan Salakaya चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतिशे नमः गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तन्नय माम चरणं My millions of dandot pranam in the lotus feet of my spiritual master Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pasi Simad Bhakti Pragyan Kishogosu And same millions of dandot pranam in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Sri Srila Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj About Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati in brief how he took birth in Jagannath Puri how he at the time of birth he had Upanayan sign of Upanayan Trikanthi Mala Tilak and everything When chariot of Jagannath Dev was coming on the door of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, chariot had stopped. So many elephants, so many persons could not move chariots. Then for 2 days or 3 days, the chariot was there. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur took his son, Vimlananda, And he took on the chariot and kept him in the feet of Jagannath Dev. At once, garland of Jagannath Dev fell down, and that was given to Srila Shishu, that boy. And at the same time,
is Annaprashan. First grain was given to the mouth of
baby.
Boy, the remnants of Jagannath, the sweet rice. And after that, he was always engaged, he was sent to school. And after that, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, as he gave him Harinam and also Kurmadev Archan Mantra, he gave. After that, when he became more aged, then he went to in Bengal, a very famous Sanskrit college. And there, Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta, he discovered a new theory of astrology. Then whole Bengal's very learned Sanskrit scholars, they gave the name, surname. Saraswati in astrology. But after some time, they were Mayavadi all. So, some dispute became then and he left the school, college. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur managed to have a very big medical shop and he engaged to be the shopkeeper. But Prabhupada has not come for this. After some time, it failed. Then he sent Kasim Bajar, king, to teach his son, and he has told very vistar.
Details.
Detail he has told. The king told Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, my wife is going to die by taking poison. So, I think that I should stop you to teach my son. But salary, what I am giving, I will give. At that time, he was giving 300 or 400 rupees. Now, equal to 10,000. But Srila Prabhupada refused. Then Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he came after retirement to Swarup Ganja, that is Godrum. And there established a bhajan kuti. And from there he discovered Mayapur, that this place is the
place
of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he bought a jamindari,
big land,
and he became like a jamindar,
landlord,
and he made a very beautiful
temple, hut,
room, but roof with grasses,
straw
grasses, and there he established Gaur Nityananda, Panchatattva, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar, Shiva Sadi, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda, and also Radha and Krishna. And also he established Srivasangan, and after that Chaitanya Math. And he gave everything to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Before this, how he took Diksha from Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, you have heard. Gaur Kishore Maharaj was blind. Why blind? Not far from his birth. When he was doing bhajan in Vrindavan, then he used to take clay of Yamuna Radha Kunda. Sometimes he used to, when he used to want to take some delicious food, very delicious food, and then very bitter neem patta.
Neem leaves.
He used to take. So,
By taking clay, he became blind. So, he refused Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati that you are son of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. You are learned in Bhakti and all type of subjects. I will ask Nityananda Prabhu, if he will allow, then I will give. But he was determined, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, I will take Diksha Valli from him. And thus he began to do Chandrayan Prat and go grass and everything. Then by the wish of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he initiated him. And then Srila Prabhupada started to preach. He established a center in Calcutta, Ulta Dinghi. And some very learned scholar became his disciple. And there our Guru Maharaj, at the age of 1916, he came to Prabhupada and he was initiated by him. And after that, so many came there and they became disciples of Prabhupada. And then what he did? He preached the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He published Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavat, Bhakti Rasami Sindhu, Hari Bhakti Vilas, Srimad Bhagavatam with Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, commentary, so many authentic books.
Bhagavad Gita.
Oh, Bhagavad Gita with so many commentary, Balde Vidya Bhushan Vishwanath Chakravarti. And preached over whole India, especially in Bengal, in Bengali language. He started daily newspaper, saptahik means
weekly
and monthly, and that monthly was Gaudiya. And after that, first he gave produce, he started to give sannyas. He saw that after Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Balde Vidya Bhushan, and between this gap of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, this time is called Andhakar Yu.
Dark age of Gaudiya.
Gaudiya.
Dark age.
Dark period of Gaudiya. Cult.
Mission.
Or a cult. Because at that time, there were so very powerful preachers. So, some took Babaji base and then they began to give Siddhadev that you are Gopi and I am engaging in this Radha Krishna night pastime or here and there. As a result, they were not qualified for this. Very soon, they collected widows and began to live with them in joy, and son and daughters began to go on. Thus whole our Gaudiya mission that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has preached, Sad Goswami has preached, after Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Baldev Vidya Bhushan, all was spoiled and all became like this. They used to take cigarette, smoke, drinking
alcohol,
taking meat and everything, still Vaishnav. So all learned scholars of Bengal began to hate Vaishnav cult. So, Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Now he started to give sannyas to very young scholar boys like our Guru Maharaj, Van Maharaj, Madhav Maharaj,
Vaikhanas Maharaj,
Puri Maharaj, Puri Maharaj,
Tirtha Maharaj,
Tirtha Maharaj, Ashram, so many,
Bharati Maharaj,
more than 100. There were very scholar. They used to write books. They used to preach in whole India, in Haridwar and Bombay, here, there, Madras, everywhere. And then Srila Prabhupada sent one Maharaj, Pradeep Tirtha Maharaj, and others in England, here, there, preaching. So he preached everywhere. And thus in a very couple of years, he preached over whole. He established preaching center in Navadvip, nine islands, in Calcutta, in Benares, in Haridwar, in Madras, in
Prayag,
Kashi, oh so many, about 84 preaching center he established. And thus he introduced sannyas and brahmachari. Sannyasi is very qualified, and he introduced it by Ramanu Sannyas, Tridandi, not Ek Dandi, not like Mayavadi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took one Danda Sannyas, but Nityananda Prabhu
broken
and
three pieces.
That became Tridanda. So, what is the meaning of Tridanda Sannyas? Whatever we do by mind, tongue, and by hands and all organs. Now, we will engage three, tan, man, vachan, in the service of Krishna. This is Tridanda Sannyas. After that, so many preachers went here and there, they became. He had established also one thing. Daiva Varnasham Dharma. In India, from ancient time, there was Varnasham Dharma, but it was a smart, you know,
by birth
who are Brahmins, their superiority. But though Sanatan Goswami has written in Hari Bhakti Vilas, in Srimad Bhagavat and all other Shastra, it has been written that those who are qualified, those they have birth in low caste, but they are qualified, they are engaged in Krishna Bhakti, they are Brahmins. Like Srila Vedavyas, he came from the womb of Khatriyani, you know, Brahman Kshatriya. But he was also worshipable for Brahmins also. Naradishi came from very low caste, but he is worshipable as Brahmins. Even by Krishna also, he used to. So we see that not only by caste, by birth, anyone, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. So he established Daiva Varnasham Dharma. And he started to give Harinam and Diksha to all, even to Muslims,
ladies,
even to Sudra, even to Americans here, there, those who were eating cow meat,
alcohol
and so many things. By his instructions and by his diksha, everyone left all these things and became pure Vaishnava. So, I think preaching in this whole world, root is Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur by the order of his father, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. His one warm was Srila Bhakti Vedanta Saraswati.
Swami Maharaj.
Swami Maharaj. But if Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati had not given all the teachings in him, teachings of Bhagavad, teachings of Ved, Upanishad, Shastra, how he could have preached? So, he preached by the influence, by
causeless mercy.
By causeless mercy and
power
of Srila Prabhupada. And then he preached a prayer. Also, wherever he used to go, he used to preach against Mayabad. Do you know Mayabad? I am Brahma. This world is false. Only Brahma is Satya. Oh, all the jivas are himself God, par Brahma. He used to cut all these arguments. At first, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cut the arguments of Vaishnava Sarvabhaum. Then,
Prakashananda Saraswati.
Prakashananda Saraswati and Sarvabhaum Bhatta. Same thing Srila Prabhupada did. He cut all the arguments and his, especially my Gurudev, by his teachings, every fact pitched against Mayabad. And he wrote a Mayabad book also. He also told, there are five kinds of knowledge. Pratyaksha, what will we see? Paroksha, like heaven. Aparoksha, that is Nirvishesh Brahma. And Prakrit, Aprakrit, that is Vaikunth and beyond even Vrindavan, Brajmandal. This is our last chance should be to serve Radha Krishna conjugal in Golok Vrindavan. And as you have heard, we should only know that our gain is topmost if we want to be the master, eternal best servant of Radhika. You should know. And then begin from Shraddha, Nishtha, Ruchi, Asakti, and then Disha. Then he also preached the Tatamya of
category
of bhakti. What we are doing, we are not in one stage. So our bhakti is like different kinds. Sakam, Nishkam, Aswarjimai Bhakti, that will lead you to Vaikuntha. Madhujimai Bhakti, it will lead us to
Golok Vrindavan.
And then Shanta, Dasyaras, Sakharas, Vasalyaras, Madhuras. These are graduations. Sadhan, Bhav, Prem, Sneh, Man, Pranay, Rag, Anurag, Bhav, Mahabhav, Rudha, Dhiru, Modan, Madan. Only this Madani is the special quality and of Radhikaji. So bhakti is, what is bhakti? Bhakti is mood of serving to Krishna of Radhika. The mood of Radhika to serve Krishna in several
gradations.
This is called bhakti. But if you want to have the service of Krishna, you will have to follow Uttama Bhakti. And the best process is gopis as Sarvati Krishna. This is the best method to have the service of Krishna. if Krishna comes to give you boon, oh, we will ask him to give the boon, that please make us the eternal maidservant of Radhika. This is our last and topest aim. So Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati preached all this mission in this world. If he had not come, the books of all the Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, were ruined. No one
would have known.
Because they were not printed. So he printed all the books and he distributed in whole India and whole world. Gaur Premanande.
And Gurudev. In the end, he said, I have not come for cupping jungle only.
Oh. He has not come to cutting jungle only. What? What meaning? Against bhakti. In this world, he cut it by his arguments, mayabad, not suddha bhakti. He cut it by his arguments, but not this is final. To serve Radha Krishna conjugal and to know the process of serving Radha Krishna, he preached to this world. This was his aim and object of our life. Any drama?
Hare Krishna, Rama, prepare for drama.